So we're going to have to go to what the big news is right now, which is this. Oh, wait, hold on. And Tom Wilson's just flagrant disregard for human life. Because you're going to see the shot right here. Buzhnevich on the save. And then just...
disgusting.
Punching a man while he's down.
First code of respect and honor violation.
Two times.
Actually, second code because he drove him down. He drove Buzhnevich down by his neck, basically Todd Bertuzzi-ing him.
I mean, I said this about Artemi Panarin when it happened live. I looked to a friend of mine and said, did his head just hit the ice? Because that's what I'm primarily concerned about. And you know who should be concerned about that? Player safety. Like, this is everything that's wrong and that they've been trying to get out of the game for a while. So now the Rangers are going to be without Artemi Panarin for the rest of the season. Wilson was fined 4 minutes and a 10-minute misconduct for all that. And then fined $5,000, no suspension. What leads to the New York Rangers releasing a statement saying that they're extremely disappointed with the NHL, that Tom Wilson was not suspended, calling him a repeat offender, which he is, and dangerous, which he is. You know what? I'll start with you, John. Take it away.
Disgusting. A disgusting and disgraceful moment for the sport of hockey, for the Washington Capitals, and what they posted on their social media afterwards, which was taken down. That was also disgusting, inciting violence. And then disgusting for the NHL, who's claimed that they've wanted this out of the game for years and years and years. And what they're going to do is they're going to sit there and basically give Tom Wilson a slap on the wrist. Not even a slap, actually, a tap on the wrist. And in the NHL, there's been a code of respect and honor amongst players in which fighting is allowed and you can police yourselves with it, as long as you stay within the boundaries of the code of honor and respect. And Tom Wilson has shown time and time and time again that he has no respect, no regard for anyone around him that isn't on his team. Anyone. And I've seen so many different takes on this. I actually watched an interview this morning with Darren McCarty, who's on this podcast with two other people. And Darren McCarty said it best, it's open season. And John Scott also said it, same thing, open season. It's disgusting, it's appalling. McCarty also said it best in terms of, you know who's on the ice around you. You know who's on the ice at all times. You know who's on the ice. And even all three of us have played for very long periods of time. You know every single person that's on that ice surface when you're on. So don't give me the defense of, oh, well, Tom Wilson didn't know who was jumping on him. He knew that there was no credible threat on the ice.
It was a power play.
It was a power play. So he knows that it's all skilled players. He's a penalty killer and has been for a while. So Tom Wilson knows that it's all skilled players on the ice. And then not only that, but you drove Pavel Buchnevich's head down into the ice like it was Todd Bertuzzi on Steve Moore. And thankfully, Pavel Buchnevich landed the way that he did, because if he landed any differently, we would be talking about another Steve Moore incident. The NHL has two TV contracts, by the way, coming up next season, as we all know, with ESPN and TNT. Does the NHL really need another black eye like this? I don't think so. I'd be hard pressed to find someone that thinks that this is good kind of PR for them. And another thing is that it's really sad that it's going to take another Steve Moore type incident where a player's career is ended for them to actually do something about it and punish this guy. He got $5,000 in a fine. You know who else got $5,000 in a fine for doing something he did? Henrik Lundqvist for squirting Sidney Crosby with a water bottle. Just put that in perspective. And you know what the sad part is about all this? Is you have players on certain teams, I'm looking at you, Washington and Pittsburgh, that get special treatment for players like this. Matt Cook, for years, was protected by the NHL for the cheap shots he put on guys like Mark Savard. Do we remember how he sliced Erik Karlsson's Achilles tendon? You want a little piece of information to take in? Something that's probably going to make you sick to your stomach here? Erik Karlsson and Matt Cook, for the incidents that they were involved in with, Erik Karlsson and Mark Savard, for the Matt Cook incidents, Matt Cook got suspended less games for those incidents than he did for when he knee-on-kneed Tyson Barrie in the 2014 playoffs. Why is that? Because Matt Cook was no longer a Pittsburgh Penguin. Because Matt Cook plays with Sidney Crosby. Because Tom Wilson plays with Alexander Ovechkin, Gary Bettman's two poster children teams, there's no punishment for him. None. He got 7 games for what he did to Brandon Carlo, and that was somehow egregious. But Shane Gostisbehere, for a little tap in the back on what's being called a boarding call, had a hearing with the Department of Player Safety. Tom Wilson got nothing for what he did to Pavel Buchnevich and Artemi Panarin, but a $5,000 fine. Not even a slap on the wrist. That's, go to your room, Tom, time out, but you can play TV and have your video games. That's what that is, and it's a joke. It's a disgrace. It's a mockery. It spits in the face of every NHL fan it is. It spits in the face of the New York Rangers, the organization itself, their fans, and every other fan in the NHL. It's a joke. And this whole Department of Player Safety, Scott Wheeler said it best. Go tear the whole damn thing down. Blow it up and start over. Get rid of Parros. Get rid of them all. Because George Parros didn't want to suspend Tom Wilson for what he did to Brandon Carlo, but Gary Bettman said, nope, we're overriding that. So it's an utter disgrace. They had a chance to take a stand and send a message here to a repeat offender. He's been fined over $1 million over his career, and he's missed 30 games. He's a repeat offender. But where is the serious punishment? There's none. 7 games is nothing. Give this guy a playoff ban. Ban him for a year. Because if either of those incidents ended with serious injury, you're not just looking at a long suspension. You're looking at a court case. You're looking at it going beyond the NHL and into the legal system.
Phil, and I gotta hold you up for a minute because you're gonna have nothing left for your editorial. Yeah.
Trust me, I will have something. Trust me.
All right, you know what? Yeah, because you were going good. There was a good 6 minutes. You were just on fire. All right. Because also, we got Anthony. He's chomping at the bit to get on this too. Did you just freeze?
As an Islander fan, I could tell you, you know, we all hate Tom Wilson too, and you know, I've into an Islander fan the other day about his ass post, but
it looks like Washington.
He ended Lubomir Rosnovsky's career. He skated behind the net and he launched himself into Vesnovsky, concussed him, dirty hit, no sort of repercussion for Wilson, and really, ever since then the guy's been. The guy's just been a repeat offender. Did you know out of all times he's been suspended, 3 of the suspensions came in preseason games? That just tells you about how much of an idiot that guy is and where his head's at, that he's throwing predatory hits in a preseason game. Why would you do that in a preseason game? Like, are you kidding me? It just shows you the level of mentality that guy has. He's dangerous. He's careless, and the sad thing is, he's a good hockey player. I hate to say it, but he's a good hockey player. He's big, he's got size, he kills penalties, he can skate, he can score. If he just got this out of his game, everyone want on a team. As it is, there's been articles that just came out saying, oh, well, every general manager, if he was available, would call on him. They'd want him on his team. Yeah, but it doesn't change the fact that the guy's a scumbag. Let's just call it like it is. He is. You know, the hit on Carlo, I mean, that guy's still having problems. It's just unbelievable that after this happened, that there was no suspension. My issue with it is that the league is coming up with the excuse of why he wasn't suspended, even though I haven't said anything. Just on reading the tea leaves and some of the articles I read today in The Athletic, like, I guarantee you the reason why he did not get suspended was because they viewed it as he didn't seek out Panarin. Panarin jumped on his back, and then from there they viewed it as just like a scrum, like a wrestling match. Okay, yeah, maybe Panarin jumped on his back. He's defending his teammate. But it was the viciousness of the way he went about it. I mean, it's like the guy snaps in the moment and he doesn't realize what he's doing. Like, for instance, Pajot mixed up with Chara a couple of games ago. Like, Chara could have easily, Chara's, yeah, he face washed him, pushed him back. Chara could have destroyed him if he wanted to. But he knows, it's not an even match. Yeah, I get it. You don't want a guy jumping on your back. He's probably pissed off. You know, just push Panarin away, face wash him. Yeah, maybe, you know, throw a little punch at him if you want, like to his head. But the fact that he went to grab the back of his jersey, yeah, maybe that was his intent. But then the fact is he got his hair, and then his other hand, he forced him back, and he, with force, threw him on the ice. And blue thankfully, for the love of God, yeah, that Panarin's shoulder hit the ice first, because if that was his head, I don't want to speculate on what would have happened. It would have been really ugly, I'll tell you that. Wilson's fortunate that Panarin didn't suffer a really, really serious injury. And not only that, but after that initial throwdown, Panarin went to get up again, and he threw him down. He just threw him back on the ice. It's like he had no regard for Panarin, and then he skates off to the penalty box like he's some steroid frat boy. He's flexing and like what are you doing? Like, are you that unhinged? Like, the whole situation was just, I'm just beyond words about how the league didn't give him a suspension. Sure, okay, some people call it a year ban or whatever, 42 games. Okay, at least give him, okay, fine, because of what you viewed it as, Panarin jumped him and, you know, it was whatever bullshit they want to come up with, at least give him 5 games. Like, show like you recognize that it was a dangerous play. Like, do something. But a $5,000 fine? I mean,
give me a break. Give me a break.
This is, it's one of the things that I'm gonna touch on Wilson, and then we're gonna go to the second part of this segment, which is that this guy just he's a danger to everyone. And they were trying to get this stuff out of the league. And instead, not only that, it's in the league. And you were talking about Steve Moore and Todd Bertuzzi, Phil. But if I recall correctly, that was the final year of the ESPN deal. So Todd Bertuzzi, by terms of time, had the longest suspension in NHL history because there was no season after that. In terms of... The heads of player safety, they got to be called into question, because the second part of the Rangers statement says that George Parros had a dereliction of duty and is unfit for this role. And they are 100% right. Awesome. For putting Stefan Quintal in charge, a guy that had a beef against the New York Rangers because of the one season he played in there that was disastrous. And then now Parros having a fighter, a guy that was exclusively a fighter with over 1,000 penalty minutes in his career, in charge of player safety, is like, I'm trying to come up with a metaphor. I can't.
I don't know if you know this, Mark. I just want to add this real quick. I don't know if you knew this, but George Parros, before they hired him, had a major brain injury at the end of his career.
I do remember that. Yeah.
Yeah. We're logic.
But, and he's also seeing it from the point of view of the enforcer. He's like, oh yeah, that stuff wasn't that bad. You had a major brain injury because of it. So, I mean, him not wanting to suspend, he didn't want to suspend Wilson at all. He ended up getting seven games. You gotta be kidding me. We went from no suspension to seven games.
Did you guys see a tweet from last year?
What?
Did you guys see Evander Kane's tweet from last year?
No, what was it?
Called out Parros for selectively suspending players. He did this in March of last year.
If you're going to be trying to say player safety, you better actually do it. And in the NFL, you know what? They argue about this all the time, but they got it right. You protect the quarterbacks. You protect your skill position. You protect the marquee players that guys want to go see. And you got Artemi Panarin, who's making close to $12 million. And he's now going to miss the next three games. Who knows if his concussion problems, if he's got a concussion, could get worse or as the time goes on. I mean, what are you doing? It's protect the people that we're paying $10 million to. And don't give me that the league needs to just police this. How about the NHLPA? Because the guy that he hit is also a member of their union. The guys that he's trying to injure are also members of their union. So, how about you guys step up, Donald Fear, and make sure the players are respecting each other? So, last words on these guys.
Yeah, I just don't get it. You have a new TV contract coming up, and you got two of them, and you want your star players in place because those are the guys that are going to put asses in the seats. They're going to have eyes viewing the TV. They're going to make people change that channel to come watch the NHL. And what do? You have a guy who isn't worth the piss on the bottom of my shoe walking on a sidewalk in New York City, going around and taking liberties at every single player that's actually worth a damn. And they're protecting him for whatever reason. I don't know whether it's a goon sympathizer, whether it's because he plays for their poster children teams, or maybe it's because, well, that's old-time hockey. That needs to change. It needs to change. So you need to protect the guys. And like you said, NHLPA represents all of them. So why is what's good for the goose is not good for the gander? Why is it? I mean, there needs to be an explanation. They need to come out and explain this, and there needs to be a change. Because what they're doing isn't working. Stop punishing the outcome. Punish the action, goddammit. Punish it. I'm tired of it. I'm sick and tired of this shit.
Anthony?
Two things, my last thoughts on this. You guys remember when Brendan Shanahan was in charge? When a player got suspended, they posted a video on social media. He just as an example, he said, in last night's game at 12:30 of the first period, Rangers defenseman Jacob Trouba laid this hit on Claude Giroux. And then he'd go through the steps, and then he'd summarize, you know, what happened and how many games he was getting. You look at this Tom Wilson thing, and you apply that same logic, it makes no sense why he wasn't suspended. Okay, one, you have the intent to injure is there. Clearly, the intent to injure is there when he threw him down the way he did. There was an injury because Shanahan also used to say player X, you know, sustained an injury as part of the reason why. Like, so Panarin got injured. So intent to injure, the player was injured, and it was predatory in nature. So why isn't he suspended? I can tell you why. It's because, again, Panarin sought out Wilson. Wilson did not seek him out. But it doesn't matter. It shouldn't matter to me, or anybody for that matter. Panarin was defending his teammate, and Wilson took it to another level. I said before, again, if Wilson just kind of wanted to shrug him off, push him, rough him up a little bit, sure. But he took it a step, way too many steps forward, in my opinion. The last thing I'll say is, I think tonight's game has the potential to be nasty, and it reminds me of what they call the fight night back at the Coliseum. I think it was 2009 or 11 against the Penguins. The Islanders felt disrespected. That was the night that Brent Johnson knocked out DiPietro. Then there was a shot of Fleury on the bench laughing about it. Early in the game, Pascal Dupuis or Max Talbot had a blatant elbow to Blake Como's head. There was no call. And the Islanders were fed up. They felt that the league didn't have their back. And that next game, they just beat the shit out of the Penguins on the scoreboard and on the ice. It was, and then Lemieux cried about it afterwards, saying, oh, blah, 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 the Islanders did this and they did that. And shut up. You employed Matt Cook on your team at the time. But the Islanders took it upon themselves and they sent a message to the league and they sent a message to the Penguins. So honestly, the Rangers should do the same thing. League's not going to have their back. Send a message to the Capitals. Send a message to the league. That's all there is to do.
Well, what I also find fascinating, and I'll say my word and I'll close this out, is that they're trying to get rid of goonery in the league. So what happens? They basically legislate it out of the game. So now you get teams like the Rangers who got rid of all their fighters. They don't have any fighters. Their closest thing to a fighter is Chris Kreider. So now you get a guy like Tom Wilson, who is, he's a goon. He's a talented player. He's a goon. But now he runs wild, can do whatever he wants, because you got rid of anybody that would police it on the ice. And then now you're going to have teams like the Rangers in the offseason looking around going, hey, you know what? We need to go find our own Tom Wilson. Okay, that's not helping the situation. If you're trying to make it get fighting out of the game, you got to get guys like Tom Wilson out of the game and let him know you can't do this, or you're sitting for 20 games, or you're sitting for 30 games, or you're sitting for 40 games. Brendan Carlo is, like we said before, still having problems. But we want to know what you think. Tom Wilson, should he have been suspended? How many games should he be suspended? Are we overreacting and he's really just an angel? To that, I'd say, where's your Capitals jersey? Obviously, like, share, and subscribe all these videos that we have. We already posted one of the comments that we got during the stream. And feel free to join us, and we'll actually post some of your comments on there.
Did you like the video? Of course you did. So why not check out some more of our content? You can check the playlist right here. Or right here.
Your ideas are intriguing to me, and I wish to subscribe to your newsletter.